Hello guys, this is Kuntal Sanjukta, and over here we have determined that whether the time period of a pendulum depends on the mass or not. To demonstrate this, first we need a pendulum that we have over here. Now we will tilt this by an angle of around 10 to 15 degrees and measure the time period. Now to say this pendulum has a length of about 3.13 meters and the mass of that block you see over there is around 20 kilos. So according to the time period formula that we have over here, T equals to 2 pi over L by G, the time period will come approximately to 3.5 seconds. Now, my time, the accuracy with which I can use this stopwatch is around 2/10 of a second or 1/10 of a second. So the pendulum, the time period of the pendulum may vary with the accuracy of 0.01 or 0.02 seconds. So let's start. I have a stopwatch over here and here is the pendulum. The center of this block is in around 15 degrees. Now, I will measure the time period by considering the moment when the walk will stop for some time. So, 1, 2, 3, 4. I will start measuring when this walk is at this position in rest. Time period is 3.54 seconds. Okay, so demonstrate this. My friend Vikram over here will measure the time with 10 oscillations. So let's start, Vikram. Okay, he will then start counting where I'm at momentary rest at the extreme height when my potential energy is maximum. Since a bit painful experiment, but since without science, we'll do it. Some other adjustments. Okay. Let's start. Ready? Oh my god. 3, 2, 1. Wow.
So it's as close as you can get.
So physics works, and the time period of the pendulum does not depend on the mass. So if it's cool and you can see it's worth seeing, then please subscribe and like the video. Thanks.